When we had record royalties that were flowing, everybody was making a decent munch off the master. When that disappeared, then the royalties from the records disappeared. And that's the problem. Nobody pays for it.
You know what? I'd like to propose a solution. And because I agree, we saw one musician post on Reddit the same grievances and the same issue about having been screwed. Create a Kickstarter project. Tell the story about what happened. Tell that you want to create a record. Come on Reddit. We'll feature you as an Ask Me Anything interview. Talk to Redditors for a day, and you will get your album funded.
Let's see if Marty Scorsese can raise $120 million for Hugo, his passion project, on Kickstarter. Give me a break. I mean, this is not realistic in any possible way.
Gentlemen, unfortunately, we only have about 30 seconds left, and I don't know if we're going to solve it in that time. Would say we have one more question, and then we'll just...
Back in March, I, like most Redditors, saw a story hit the front page that really affected me. It was just a few months after we had successfully defeated two terrible bills in Washington, SOPA and PIPA. Thanks for that, by the way. And this photo, front paged on Reddit, was seen by millions of people all across the world, including me. It was a photo of a musician named Lester Chambers holding up one of his gold records in front of his face with a sign beneath it that talked about how for decades, after producing album after album, hit after hit, he saw no money from the music industry. And that's why I'm here in California right now. You see, a little while ago, I got in touch with Lester Chambers and his son, Dylan. And I pitched Lester on an idea. I wanted Bread Pig to produce his newest album. Now, we're a book publisher. We make geeky things. We donate the non-sustainable profits. We really don't know the first thing about making a record. The good news is we don't have to. The pitch to Lester was simple. Lester, if you can put together an album of music that is all your own, or that is in the public domain, and you can figure out what it's gonna cost to get the studio time and actually put it together, we'll give you total control, because you're the artist. We're not. And we'll also give you all the profits, because you're the artist, and we're not. And we'll make sure that we get that album funded. It's time we, the fans, we, the people, actually give him the support that he deserves and has longed for so long.
Hey guys,
hey,
I'm Alexis.
What's up, Alexis?
How you doing?
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Did you have a nice trip?
Oh, very good trip.
Great
very
man.
Good trip.
Great.
Dylan. What's
happening? I just love making people happy. I love seeing people dance. I love seeing people smile. If it hadn't been for me having music to go back to after cancer and all that stuff, I would have probably sat down and drank myself to death too.
So could you talk a little about how that all went down with the record company and the contract and everything?
Well, the record companies are the worst sharecroppers in the world. Bob Dylan, he invited us to come to New York where he was recording at Columbia Records, and John Hammond asked for us to come by, Senior asked for us to come by his office after the recording. And he said, I'm gonna give you guys a recording contract. We signed a contract in a restaurant that was so dark you had to lean down to see. But they sat there and explained it to us so clearly. And this is gonna happen like this, and oh, you're gonna have this, and we're gonna do this for you, and we're gonna do that for you. And we're at the dinner table, you know, with these people and thinking, these are good people. We didn't know any different. None of us are lawyer educated. So we signed the contract.
So you assumed, you know,
we assumed that we would be getting royalties and residuals and stuff like that, and they have never offered to pay us one penny of royalties. I'd love to know that I didn't spend all the years accept my whole age like this, working for free, and I have. It's hard to just come out and say, I'm broke. I need help. It's real hard, because people don't want to believe you. And number one, they think, well, he's an alcoholic, or he's a drug addict. That's the first two things they think. So they're not gonna help you. My son, Michael Dillon, said, Dad, don't worry. I'm never gonna leave you. I'll always stay by your side. He slept on the floor with me. When I didn't have nothing to eat, he didn't. And he's, God, he's the most. Every father in the world should have a son like I have.
The thing that we do with the profits Bread Pig normally takes is we find a nonprofit that's related to donate them to. You guys beat me to the punch because you already had some plans for Sweet Relief, which is the nonprofit you want a percentage of the proceeds from this album to go to. Can you tell us about Sweet Relief?
Well, Sweet Relief is the reason I'm in this house and you're in my living room. Because prior to Sweet Relief, me and my son was homeless, and the results is I'm not homeless anymore. I got food in my refrigerator. You know, it's just a wonderful thing what Sweet Relief does.
Let me ask you this, why do you trust me? Or is it because there are cameras here while we're talking about it?
No, that's because of what Reddick do for people. Now here we are, doing it.
I'm ready to make this record.
All right. So am I.
Excellent. Let's do this.
Artists like Lester represent something that we in the internet can change. I'd be devastated to think about all the potential innovation, all the potential genius, all the potential awesomeness that we would miss out on without an open internet. The new technologies that are emerging online are actually connecting artists to their fans and cutting out the middlemen that in many cases historically have taken advantage of their talents. The innovation we're building using this great platform can actually help connect artists to fans like never before. We're so excited to finally say that Lester's time has come.